celebration of the Holy Family of Jesus, Mary, and Joseph. Presiding at this liturgy is Father Mike. Our altar servers are Sarah Schuneman and Jesse Schuneman. Our music is provided by the Sounds of the Spirit. I am Peter Schaefer, your commentator. Our lector is Phil Cirque. Our processional hymn will be number 522, Joy to the World. Please stand.
Let us begin in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
And we celebrate the Holy Family. And after yesterday and all the preparation, I'm sure you're familiar with each one of them. Isn't it an interesting and wonderful plan that God has for us? Instead of just saying, let Michael be, or Thomas be, or, you know, Susan, and poof, like creation in Genesis, he says the word, and there it is. When it came to us, we come through family. We don't get here alone. We come through community. Trinity is community, three in one. We come in a community, a family. That is a powerful message that Jesus preaches, the interconnectedness of us with each other. And so we celebrate that Jesus too came to a family, and he was just like you and me. He had his good days, he had his bad days. The same for us. And we ask, as we prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred liturgy, we ask that he forgive our faults and makes us better family members, community members. We say, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting.
We're
God, who were pleased to give us the shining example of the Holy Family, graciously grant that we may imitate them in practicing the virtues of family life and the bonds of charity, and so in the joy of your house, delight one day in eternal rewards. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
A reading from the first book of Samuel. In those days, Hannah conceived, and at the end of her term bore a son, whom she called Samuel, since she had asked the Lord for him. The next time her husband Elkanah was going up with the rest of his household to offer customary sacrifices to the Lord and to fulfill his vows, Hannah did not go, explaining to her husband, "Once the child is weaned, I will take him to appear before the Lord and to remain there forever. I will offer him as a perpetual Nazarite." Once Samuel was weaned, Hannah brought him up with her, along with a 3-year-old bull, an ephah of flour, and a skin of wine, and presented him at the temple of the Lord in Shiloh. After the boy's father had sacrificed the young bull, Hannah, his mother, approached Eli and said, "Pardon, my lord. As you live, my lord, I am the woman who stood near you here praying to the Lord. I prayed for this child, and the Lord granted my request. Now I, in turn, give him back to the Lord. As long as he lives, he shall be dedicated to the Lord." Hannah left Samuel there. The word of the Lord. A reading from the first letter of St. John. Beloved, See what love the Father has bestowed on us, that we may be called the children of God. And so we are. The reason the world does not know us is that it did not know him. Beloved, we are God's children now. What we shall be has not yet been revealed. We do know that when it is revealed, we shall be like him, for we shall see him as he is. Beloved, if our heart does not condemn us, we have confidence in God and receive from him whatever we ask, because we keep his commandments and do what pleases him. And his commandment is this: we should believe in the name of his Son, Jesus Christ, and love one another just as he has commanded us. Those who keep his commandments remain in him, and he in them. And the way we know that he remains in us is from the Spirit he gave us. The word of the Lord.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord.
Each year, Jesus' parents went to Jerusalem for the feast of the Passover. And when he was 12 years old, they went up according to festival custom. After they had completed its days, as they were returning, the boy Jesus remained behind in Jerusalem, but his parents did not know it. Thinking he was in the caravan, they journeyed for a day and looked for him among their relatives and acquaintances. But not finding him, they returned to Jerusalem to look for him. After 3 days, they found him in the temple, sitting in the midst of the teachers, listening to them and asking them questions. And all who heard him were astonished at his understanding and his answers. When his parents saw him, they were astonished. And his mother said to him, "Son, why have you done this to us? Your father and I have been looking for you with great anxiety." He said to them, "Why were you looking for me? Did you not know that I must be in my father's house?" But they did not understand what he said to them. He went down with them and came to Nazareth and was obedient to them. And his mother kept all these things in her heart. And Jesus advanced in wisdom and age and favor before God and man. The gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. On Holy Family Weekend, a story about family life. During the winter of 1993, construction workers at the Baseball Hall of Fame in Cooperstown made a heartwarming discovery. While remodeling a section of the museum, they found a photograph that someone had stuck in a crevice underneath one of the display cases. The man was smiling in the picture. He had a bat resting on his shoulders. He was wearing a baseball uniform with the word Sinclair Oil on the uniform. Stapled to the picture was a note scribbled in pen, and it said, "You were never too tired to play ball. On your days off, you helped build the Little League field. You always came to watch me play. You were a Hall of Fame dad. I wish I could share this moment with you. Your son, Peter." A son named Peter had managed to find a way to put his dad in the baseball's Hall of Fame in Cooperstown. Within our own families, we experience the height of joy and the depths of pain. Memories we treasure, values we learn in our families are the most important we will ever learn. Our belonging to a family means that each one of us, parents and child, reflects for one another a selfless, limitless, and unconditional love of Christ, both in good times and in the difficult times, more importantly. The Holy Family, Joseph, Mary, and the child Jesus, is a model. Read the Gospels. Read between the lines. And you will see the interaction going on in a normal family. A lot like yours and mine. They are models. And as we confront the many tensions and crises that threaten the stability of a family, we pray for that peace and unity and the joys of being a member of a family. Have you really considered today's gospel? Having been in high school work for most of my career, this gospel gets my attention. Because Jesus is 12. He is very close to the magical years of teenager. And every parent says, We have a tendency to look at Jesus and all the theology and the plan of God for him. And we kind of gloss over he was a normal kid. He was a normal person. And where you find him is out among the people, and you get these glimpses that he's just like the boy next door. And the people of his time had a problem with that. They knew him. Their experiences of him were an ordinary kid in the neighborhood. And yet now he's going around and claiming some outlandish things. "I'm the Son of God. The Father and I are one." And they said, "We know Joseph, a carpenter. We know your mom. We know who you are. What is
this. He was so ordinary. Today's gospel, I just love it because he really is acting like a teenager. He all of a sudden comes up missing. They go to the big city, and he decides to go off on his own. And guess what? He didn't tell his mom and dad. And all of a sudden, they're going home, and they look around, and where is he? He's missing in action. Doesn't that sound like many conversations you had in your family with your mom or your dad saying, where were you last night? You had a curfew. Tell me where you were. You came up missing, and you don't appreciate we're going nuts, having you in the hospital and everywhere else. And of course, the teenager is oblivious. You know, well, why did you think that? You know, but we've all experienced it. And here, there's the Holy Family. They had a lot of good times, and they had some rough times as a family. And Mary, especially towards the end, had a rough time with what was going on in her family. So they are very much like us. A lot of things came up in that family, and when he was 12, he got lost. The parents really got ticked off. And you can only imagine what was not written down for the gospel, what was said. I think he got the message. Because after he said, well, I thought what I was doing was okay because it was my father's house and I belong where my father is. And of course, Mary and Joseph are not going to connect those dots. They're not going to get what that means, that the temple was where Jesus resides with his father. They weren't ready for that. That would have to come over time. But what happened here was they let him know, you better not do that again. You better let us know what's going on here. Because we love you, and when there's a mystery here or something's going on, we don't know about it, we do what every parent does. And the interesting thing for the children of the family is he was just like you as a teenager. What was his response? His response was, well, I guess it's an opportune time to tell me who I am. That I am the one who made the universe. I am the creator. I am who am. He didn't go that route. He didn't pull that card. He left with them and was obedient to them. And I would imagine when he got home, he knew what the penalty was going to be. You can fantasize it. I could ask you, give me the top three. His dad was a carpenter. Guess who's going to clean the shop for the next month? Guess who's going to do the chores? Guess who's going to be on time for lunch and dinner? Guess who's going to ask, you need any help, Mom? Normal kid. But he was so much more that we find out. And I think maybe keep that in mind about our families as we have the good times and the rough times. That the love there is indispensable for us growing as a human being. It's where we get the foundation. It's where we get our start. And we won't get very far without it. And that basically, we have to trust one another, love one another. It's God's plan. And Jesus was just like us, experienced everything human. And our goal is to become like him. And here, he's a good member of the family. He goes back into the house, and he knows his role in that community. And I'll bet you he did that role as well as he could to perfection, that he did the will of his Father at the end. And we're all called to be like that for one another in the family. So right after the nativity, it's good to reflect that Jesus didn't stay a baby. He didn't stay in the crib. And we have this nice story of him growing up and maturing. And he matured on every level. And the best one was he matured as a member of a community, a family. And he grew in age, wisdom, and grace, just like us. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Let us now respond to the gospel with our profession of faith through the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there, he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Let us now put our knees before our Father, who always listens and answers all of our prayers.
For the family of God's holy church, as we strive to love one another as Jesus commanded us, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For parents, may their sacrificial and life-giving love be a source of hope and inspiration. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are estranged from their families, and for those who have no family, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For families of all kinds, that they might know and show the mercy of God during this Jubilee year of mercy. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of our sick, Marietta DeMauro, Michael Dewey, Mary Martorano, Elise Olson, Jackie Page, Bud Schultz, and Bob Williams, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Darlene Angelo, for whom this Mass is offered, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our unspoken needs, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Heavenly Father, we put all our needs before you in prayer, confident you will hear and answer us again through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
The ushers will bring our gifts to the altar. As we offer our lives, along with our tithes, let us sing hymn number 540, The Snow Lay On. Pray that my sacrifice and yours may be made acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
The Lord accepts sacrifice at your hands. For the praise of the Lord and his name, for our good and the Church.
Lord, we offer you the sacrifice of conciliation, humbly asking that through the intercession of the Virgin Mother of God and Saint Joseph, you may establish our families firmly in your grace and in your peace. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Holy Father, almighty eternal God, for in the mystery of the Word made flesh, a new light of your glory has shone upon the eyes of our minds, so that as we recognize in him God made visible, we may be caught up through him in the love of things invisible. And so with all the angels we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples and said, "Take this, all of you, and eat it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the cup and once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples and said, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the cup of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life, the cup of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Paul, our Bishop, and all those engaged in your ministry. Remember your servant, Darlene Angelo, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that she, who was united with your Son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Saint Joseph, the apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Let us now sing together the way the Lord has taught us.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days. By the help of your mercy, may we always be free from sin and safe from all distress. As we await the blessed hope and coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever." Amen. May the peace of the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of that peace. This is the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are those who are called to his supper. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. May the body and blood of Christ bring us to life everlasting.
As we enter into communion with the Lord, please join in singing number 551, What Child Is This? Number 551. Your baby boy would one day walk on water. Mary, did you know that your baby boy would save our sons and daughters? Did you know that your baby come to make you new? This child that you delivered would
The nice stuff they did getting us in the spirit at Christmas time and today and every time they come. So we thank them for their contribution. If there are any of my shorter friends, fun-filled friends, want to come up and get a blessing.
We've got a couple, so start playing.
That's right, the bowl games are on, aren't they?
They're coming. I hear the door opening. Trading my sorrow, I'm trading my shame, I'm laying them down for the joy of the Lord. I'm trading my sickness, I'm trading my pain, I'm laying them down for the joy of the Lord. And we say, yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes, yes, Lord. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes, yes, Lord. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes, yes, Lord, amen. Amen. We're not used to doing it without the band. We're like, wait, what?
There will be a youth mass tomorrow evening here at St. Bernard's at 5 p.m. The parish pictorial directories are being handed out after masses this weekend to those that had their pictures taken. And there is this book, Rediscover Jesus, that you will find near the entrances. Anyone that didn't get one last week, please take one home with you. Please check the bulletin for the Holy Day schedule for the Solemnity of Mary, Mother of God, next weekend. The parish office will be closed Thursday and Friday for New Year's. We conclude our celebration with hymn number 534, Go Tell It on the Mountain.
Most merciful Father, bring those you refresh with this heavenly sacrament to imitate constantly the example of the Holy Family, so that after the trials of this world, we may share their company forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Almighty God, bless us, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is ended. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
And you can come to Mass on
Thursday,
first of the year, in preparation for the Fiesta Bowl, where you will be absolutely perfect to watch the Irish. I hope there are no Buckeye fans here. Okay.
Don't forget about the Spartans on Thursday.
I can live with that. The Spartans are going to win.
I know.
Yeah. You heard it here. Right? And if you want to complain, see Father Bill. Right. Well, enjoy the holidays. If your relatives are still there, still be nice to them. All right? But enjoy. Enjoy it. Once a year it comes.
Thank you once again. Our closing song is number 534, Go Tell It on the Mountains, number 534.